Hello students, welcome to our channel Learning Notebook. In today's video, we are going to do an activity to understand transversal and angles made by transversal. But before starting with this video, let me tell you that we have many more such maths art integrated activities, projects and working models on our channel Learning Notebook. You can find the list of all of them on our website as well. The link to our website is below in the description box. For this activity, we need few white sheets, a ruler, a black marker pen, a pencil, a compass, a pair of scissors, and a box of crayons. Aim of this art integrated project is to verify that if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then first, the pairs of corresponding angles are equal. Second, the pairs of alternate interior angles are equal. Third, the pairs of alternate exterior angles are equal. And fourth, the pairs of interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. So, we are going to verify all of these with the help of this activity. If you are enjoying watching videos on our channel, then do like, share and comment on our videos. Also, do not forget to subscribe to our channel Learning Notebook. So, first let's understand what is transversal. A line which intersects two or more lines at different points is called a transversal. Like here, line P intersects line L and M at two different points. Therefore, line P is a transversal. Now, can you think of any real life example of transversal? Yes, the roads. The roads which cross each other, as shown here, are real life example of transversal. A transversal, when intersects with two parallel lines, make eight angles, as shown here. Now students, out of these eight angles, the four angles which are on exterior side, that is angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8 are called exterior angles, while the angles which lie in the interior side, that is angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 are called interior angles. Now next, let's see what are corresponding angles made by transversal. Here, angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. Similarly, angle 2 and angle 6 are also corresponding angles. Then, angle 4 and angle 8 are also corresponding angles. And angle 3 and angle 7 are corresponding angles as well. We just learned about interior angles. Now let's understand alternate interior angles made by transversal. Here, angle 4 and angle 6 are alternate interior angles. Similarly, angle 3 and angle 5 are also alternate interior angles made by this transversal. Students, we learned that angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8 are exterior angles. But angle 1 and angle 7 are alternate exterior angles. Similarly, angle 2 and angle 8 are alternate exterior angles made by the transversal. Now we learned that interior angles are 3, 4, 5 and 6. But angles which are on same side of transversal are angle 4 and angle 5. And another set of interior angles which are on same side of transversal are angle 3 and angle 6. We also have an interesting activity on how to solve linear equation in one variable. I would recommend you to watch this video. You will find the link to this video below in the description box. Now let's start with this activity. In the first step, take a white sheet of paper and draw two parallel lines AB and CD on it. Then draw a transversal EF which intersect these two parallel lines AB and CD. Now students, taking both the intersecting points as center, draw two circles as shown here. Earlier, I told you that a transversal makes 8 angles. So let's name these angles 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, with the help of scissors, let's cut out these angles. Students, we have many activities on integers like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of integers. I'm sure you will find these videos very useful for you. Now first let's see interior and exterior angles. Now let's first color exterior angles. Exterior angles lie on the exterior side of the transversal. So angle 1, angle 2, angle 6 and angle 7 are exterior angles. So color them with your favorite color. Next, we will color interior angles. Interior angles lie on the interior side of the transversal. So angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 8 are interior angles. Now next, let's see corresponding angles. Students, we have already learned what are corresponding angles. Now, we have to prove that pairs of corresponding angles are equal. To prove this, let's make another set of these 8 angles. Now, place the cutout of angle 1 on angle 8. We see that angle 1 covers angle 8 completely. This means angle 1 equals to angle 8. Color the first pair of corresponding angles with orange color. Now let's place the cutout of angle 2 on angle 5. We see that angle 2 completely covers angle 5. So this means the second pair of corresponding angles are also equal. That is, angle 2 equals to angle 5. Students, color the second pair of corresponding angles with green color. Now, we will place the cutout of angle 3 on angle 6. Again, we find that angle 3 completely covers angle 6. This means that third pair of corresponding angles are also equal. So, angle 3 equals to angle 6. Color this third pair of corresponding angles in purple color. Now, let's move to fourth pair of corresponding angles. So, let's put angle 4 on angle 7. Again, we see that angle 4 completely covers angle 7. So, the fourth pair of corresponding angles are also equal. That is, angle 4 equals to angle 7. Now, let's color this fourth pair of corresponding angles in yellow color. So, we have proved that the pair of corresponding angles made by transversal are equal. Students, we have many activities on algebraic expressions like how to add, subtract, and multiply the given algebraic expressions. So, I would recommend you to watch these videos. The link to these videos are below in the description box. Now, next is alternate interior angles. Now, second aim of this project is to prove that pairs of alternate interior angles are equal. That is, we have to prove that angle 4 equals to angle 5 and angle 3 equals to angle 8. So, for this, let's make another set of these 8 angles. Now, place the cutout of angle 4 on angle 5 as shown here. We see that angle 4 completely covers angle 5. It means that the first pair of alternate interior angles are equal. Now, let's place angle 3 on angle 8 as shown here. Again, we find that angle 3 completely covers angle 8. So, it means second pair of alternate interior angles are also equal. So, students, we have proved that pair of alternate interior angles made by transversal are equal. Students, we also have interesting activities to prove Pythagoras theorem in different ways. I am sure you will find these videos useful for you. Now, the next is alternate exterior angles. Now, third aim of this project is to prove that pairs of alternate exterior angles are equal. That is, angle 1 equals to angle 6 and angle 2 equals to angle 7. So, for this, let's make another set of these 8 angles. Now, place the cutout of angle 1 on angle 6 as shown here. We see that angle 1 completely covers angle 6. So, it means that the first pair of alternate exterior angles are equal. That is, angle 1 equals to angle 6. Similarly, let's place the cutout of angle 2 on angle 7. Again, we find that angle 2 completely covers angle 7. So, it means the second pair of alternate exterior angles are also equal. So, in this way, we have proved that a pair of alternate exterior angles made by transversal are equal. Students, if you want to learn the chapter quadrilaterals with the help of an interesting activity, then I would recommend you to watch this video. The link to this video is below in the description box. Now, the next topic is interior angles on same side of transversal. Now, fourth aim of this project is to prove that the pairs of interior angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary. That is, we have to prove that angle 4 plus angle 8 equals to 180 degrees, and angle 3 plus angle 5 equals to 180 degrees. So for this, let's make another set of these 8 angles. And now take angle 4 and angle 8 and place them as shown here. Students, with the help of a ruler, we have to check that their non-common arms are in straight line. So it means angle 4 and angle 8 are supplementary angles. Similarly, let's take angle 3 and angle 5 and place them as shown here. Again, we will take the help of a ruler to check that their non-common arms are in straight line. So it means angle 3 plus angle 5 equals to 180 degrees. So we have proved that the pair of interior angles on same side of transversal are supplementary angles. Now students, let's assemble our project. Take a white chart paper and write the heading on it, angles made by transversal. So students, first we proved that pair of corresponding angles made by transversal are equal. That is, angle 1 equals to angle 8, angle 2 equals to angle 5, angle 3 equals to angle 6, and angle 4 equals to angle 7. Next, we proved that pair of alternate interior angles made by transversal are equal. In this, we proved angle 4 equals to angle 5 and angle 3 equals to angle 8. Next, we proved that pair of alternate exterior angles made by transversal are equal. That is, angle 1 equals to angle 6 and angle 2 equals to angle 7. And in the end, we proved that pair of interior angles on same side of transversal are supplementary. That is, angle 4 plus angle 8 equals to 180 degrees, and angle 3 plus angle 5 equals to 180 degrees. So students, do try this activity to learn about transversal and angles made by transversal. And do watch our other videos also. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.